This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. This is part of a series of videos where we're going to be solving more complicated trigonometric equations where we might need to use these methods: factoring, the quadratic formula, or other methods for solving quadratics. We might have to use trig identities. We might have to square both sides. We also might be dealing with multiple angles. Keep in mind that if anytime you square both sides of an equation, it's essential that you check solutions for extraneous roots. All right, so we're going to solve this equation, finding solutions in 0 to 2 pi. First thing I notice, I've got a tangent of x and I have a cotangent of x. So I'm going to put everything in terms of tangent of x. So I've got tangent of x plus 1 equals square root of 3 plus, all right, now remember, this is square root of 3 times the cotangent of x, which is 1 over the tangent of x. So that square root of 3 is still in the numerator, but I have a tangent of x in the denominator. Now, since this is an equation with fractions, you can multiply both sides by the least common denominator to eliminate the fraction. So I'm going to go ahead and multiply both sides of the equation by tangent of x. So on the left-hand side, I'm just going to leave it factored. That's tangent of x times the tangent of x plus 1. Okay. And on the right side, I'm going to have square root of 3 times the tangent of x plus, all right, now when I multiply by the second term, the tangent of x cancel and I have square root of 3. Notice on the left-hand side, I could have multiplied that out, tangent squared x plus tangent of x. And over here on the right-hand side, how if I put that in factored form, what happens? If I just trying to just keep each side factored for a moment, I have a common factor of square root of 3, so this is tangent of x plus 1. I have a common factor on each side. Now, we can't just divide by that, but we could subtract so that we have everything equal to 0, and since we have a common factor here, we're going to be able to factor out a common factor. So I have tangent of x times tangent of x plus 1 minus, this is like a whole big term, minus the square root of 3 tangent of x plus 1, right? I'm taking that whole term and setting it equal to 0. And now I have a common factor of tangent of x plus 1. Now let's say you didn't do that. You would have had tangent, let's say you had multiplied all that out. You'd have tangent squared x plus tangent of x minus square root of 3 tangent of x minus square root of 3 equals 0. Okay, you could have gotten to this point. But then the next step is when you have four terms to factor by grouping. So that's what I have on this step up here. I left it factored to see if it might work by factoring by grouping. So if you'd done this first, then the next step would have been to group these first two factors together, and there you go, this tangent of x times tangent of x plus 1, and then factor out the minus square root of 3, and you'd have the other tangent of x plus 1. So different ways you might have gotten to this spot right here. And now the greatest common factor is tangent of x plus 1 times, got left, the tangent of x minus square root of 3 equals 0. This is a hard problem, I'll tell you something. I tried it a few other ways, changing things to sines and cosines, etc., and I didn't get anywhere, and that happens a lot. You're working on a problem, you try something, and it just starts getting worse, so you try something else. Okay, now that I've factored it when it's equal to 0, I set each factor equal to 0. So tangent of x can equal negative 1, or tangent of x equals root 3. So let's find the first place where you're going to have a tangent of negative 1. It's negative in quadrant 2. That's the 45 degree angle. And we are asked to put this, I think, between in radians. So it'll be 3 pi over 2 for this one. I'm sorry, 4. 3 pi over 4. It's 135 degrees. And then remember, it's pi units apart from each other. So if you add pi to that, that's like adding 4 pi over 4 pi. The other one's 7 pi over 4, right? Okay, so we're going to get the two solutions if I were doing it in radians. If you had done this in degrees, that's fine, and thought of it as a 135 degrees and then 315 degrees, you should be able to then, of course, change it to radians. All right, now where's the tangent square root of 3? Okay, so that's going to be positive in the first and third quadrant. I'm going to draw a little picture for that one. Tangent is the y over x, so that actually is going to be up here, right? Square root of 3 over 1. At 60 degrees, or pi over 3. And if you add pi to that, what's the other path? That's that getting 3 pi over 3, so it's 4 pi over 3. So you have four solutions for this. I didn't square both sides of the equation, so there should be no problem with extraneous roots, but it's always a good idea to check all four of them in the original. But here I do have all my solutions. You could put them in from smallest to largest, any order you want. Let's see, pi over 3 if I do that. Next would be 3 pi over 4. And then I would have the 4 pi over 3 and 7 pi over 4. And again, to check it, you would take one of these and plug it into the original equation, which was up here. Where is it? Here it is. You'd have to plug it into this original equation you see right here. Simplify each side and make sure that you get the same exact number on each side. It does work, but I'm going to leave that for you to do. But for now, these are the solutions to this problem. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.